people didn't know, if they just looked at the lyrics, read the lyrics, and listened to the music, they think, wow, these guys are pretty heavy and serious, but in real life, you're not.
Right. Well, it'd be pretty boring if we were, like, all uptight all the time. I don't know. We just, that kind of just how it works. It's not really thought out, you know?
Why would you be like that all the time? What would you be like, Danzig, just angry punching kids in the face all the time? A lot of the stuff's kind of funny to us, but then other people don't perceive it the same way, so they kind of, you know, oh, ooh, that's, mm-hmm. you know, but to us, by the time it comes out, it's pretty funny. I feel so alone.
Did really well when it came out right away, better than Facelift.
Yeah.
But Facelift has really sort of gathered momentum, and more so even with the release of Dirt.
Mm-hmm.
So how do you feel right now about the albums?
They're round.
No.
If you feel them, they're round. Like you can feel them.
They're round and smooth and shiny.
You did this
you
long
see
time
yourself.
Too.
You can see yourself.
It's cool. I mean, we're having a good time. It's kind of unexpected, actually. You know, we thought it would do good, but we didn't think it'd do this good.
I thought something very specific, didn't I?
We didn't think it'd be that nifty and neato, but with Seattle being so peachy keen and such a trendy, hip, swinging place nowadays, no wonder.
Are you happy with the success you've had so far? Is it important to you to go further? Are you hoping this album like will keep going and going and going?
Yeah.
It's doing well.
It'll do whatever it does. I don't give a shit what it does.
It'll appeal to
who it appeals to. I hope it does well, and it's doing better than
we made the record for ourselves.
And the first record did better than we thought too.
And you thought it would?
Yeah, so.
Gain momentum, I said.
Yeah, so whatever happens with it is what everybody else did. I mean, we did our thing. We did our part, and we'll go play.
Hook up with Cameron Crowe.
Well, he lives up in that area. He's married to Nancy from Heart, and our manager Kelly has a lot of history with Heart and stuff. So he didn't make that one. He didn't make that one. Anyway, we just kind of met by hanging out up there. You know, I mean, it's not that big of a city. You know, so we ended up meeting through like our manager, meeting the Wilson sisters and Cameron. And Cameron was making this movie and. He was interested in the band from like Facelift and stuff, and we wanted to hear some songs, so we demoed. We had a demo tape of about 10 songs or something that we gave him.
Thank you.
And he picked one.
That's pretty good.
Picked one out. Hey, it's not bad. He used to work in a circus.
What's the best thing about it? About the industry, about the business that you're in.
The industry? Nothing.
The industry, well,
nothing.
About the
we get to play. That's the best part.
Yeah.
We get to go do what we like to do 1 hour a day, but then, you know, 1 or 2 hours a day, you play, and then you spend 22 hours with just nothing to do or, you know.
What are the perks?
The perks?
Outside of playing.
You get to see sights. If you have days off, if you're not too hungover, anything.
Travel's pretty cool.
Yeah, you get.
But it gets old sometimes though.
Yeah, when you get up, if you want to, and you go see things, you know. And then you go around towns, you meet a lot of people, friends, and you know.
Do you ever get tired of moving around so much? Like, it must be hard to sort of have relationships, you know.
I thought I would.
Longer than 2 weeks.
I thought I would get,
that
like,
part of it.
I thought I'd get really tired of it. But then it's like when I go home, I go stir crazy. I can't sit in one place for a while. So because I'm real.
It's like it's a love-hate thing. It's like, you know, if you're sitting
you
home,
hate it while you're out for a while, but then as soon as you go home, you go crazy within a week. Yeah. You're like, get me out of here, I gotta go somewhere.
It gets old getting into, like, different hotels every day and this and that. You know, it gets kind of feeling alone, like being in a massive crowd and feeling alone, that type of feeling.
Yeah.
But also at the same time, like you said, you know, you gotta move. It's in your blood, you know. It's like you've been doing it so long. If you don't do it, it's even worse, you know.
Yeah.
It's, oh, God, I gotta get out of this place.
Round over my time. Soir à la Brique, un programme triple. Trois groupes de Seattle. Alice in Chains avec en première partie Screaming Trees et Grand Truck. Le chanteur d'Alice in Chains, Lane Staley, se remet tranquillement d'un accident qu'il a eu en septembre dernier alors qu'il conduisait un véhicule tout-terrain. Résultat, eh bien, il a passé quelques semaines dans une chaise roulante avec une jambe dans le plâtre. En plus, il se remet de sa dépendance à l'héroïne, mais vous allez voir que maintenant, il a les idées très claires. Recently you had an accident in September and you ended up in a wheelchair with a cast and all that, but you did the shows anyways, you didn't mind, so how did it go?
It went good.
Yeah?
I didn't break my neck, so there's no excuse not to play.
Anything funny or wild happened during one of these shows?
Hey! I don't recall anything too crazy.
No.
He jumped out in the crowd with his cast. So I thought that was kind of nutty. Very nutty. Kind of crazy.
Very angry at you.
So how is it going now? It's okay? Your leg is okay?
Still hurts, but I can walk, so. I can walk! I can see! Wow.
When you have a problem with heroin, does it automatically make you think about death because you're playing with your life a lot? Or?
Yeah, I suppose that comes with the territory. You're flirting with death, and that's probably what's most attractive about it at first, is the danger, you know. But I beat it. I beat death. I'm immortal.
And talking about death so much in your lyrics, did it make it less frightening to you?
No, that's why we write about things like that, because it is frightening. It's just, it's a reminder of how scary that is.
What's the hardest?
The herring, the fish.
The fish.
Yes.
What's the hardest part when you're trying to get over that?
Cravings, probably.
At one point, has it been an excuse for creativity?
No, I never created anything when I was in that state of mind. It was only when I stopped that I could create.
Do you believe in life after death?
Yeah.
What kind?
I think I will come back in form of a small...
Sturgeon.
A small aquatic creature, or possibly something from the insect world. Something interesting, something large. And maybe an Amazonian beetle.
He's going to come back
as a giant penis.